Hi folks, time for another update on the J.A.P 3. It's coming on pretty well because I now have, courtesy of fellow YouTuber Calm Callum, a set of piston rings for it. So thanks very much for sending these to me. Hope you got the connecting rod alright. The oil scraper ring is not something I've used before. It's quite a different type. You put the ring there into the ring groove, and then you put these two like expander rings, you put them on the outside and they just clamp it in place. And if I push that down, as you can see, the ring groove is plenty deep enough, so that's the correct one for the piston. The rings are also stepped, so you've got a little step on the top one that goes that way up, and then there's a mark that says top on the other one, which is chamfered. It's kind of tapered, so you have to make sure you get them the right way up. Anyway, so we're going to try and get the piston in the engine tonight. I guess I'll get the cylinder head on. I've also got the steel work for the trolley. Bag full of stainless bolts there, so we should be able to make a good job of whatever we do. I've got some handles for it. I'm going to do a barra type affair, and I've got the wheels painted, and I've got some bright mild steel bar for the axle. Right, so I fitted up the piston rings, piston's in, turns over nicely. So to put the copper gasket in place, and I'm now sealing the push rod tube, and then I can drop the cylinder head in place. Put a bit of sealant around there first. You need to put the push rods in at this stage before you drop this over, so you can make sure they locate on the lifters there. So then we'll see if we can tighten the head down properly. Okay, well, just to end the video, as you can see, it runs not particularly well, but it goes. So that's quite a big milestone considering the state it was in when I bought it in September 2013, full of acorns and all that, but got it unseized and stripped apart okay. I think it's come out quite well, I'm pleased with it. Bit of a swine to work on, I don't think I'd do another one, but quite an interesting little engine. I had great difficulty getting it to run. Had the timing case cover off twice before I realised what the problem was, and the crux of it was that I've converted a twin cylinder MC magneto, BTH MC, I've converted a twin cylinder to a single, so it still has the pickups on the slip ring section of the rotor for the twin, but I've only got one HT pickup, if that makes sense. So I had it timed 180 degrees out. Couldn't understand it, the points were opening at what appeared to be the right time. But like I say, 180 degrees out, so sorted that and away she went. But still plenty of room for improvement. A few things I can do. Tomorrow I'm gonna start on the trolley. I've got this steel channel for that, just mild steel. And I've got some nice bright steel bar for the axle. What I'm gonna do is weld some box section underneath, poke the axle through that because it's a snug fit. Got a nice pair of cast iron wheels, and I've got two barrow handles, like the sort of thing you'd see on the original Amanco trolleys, and a couple of stretcher supports for the other end from an old Canadian Army stretcher, World War II era, so it'll all look kind of in keeping. Anyway, hope you enjoyed the video, and thank you very much for watching.